The main focus of our work in the early days was wind effects on tall buildings. And we had done a tremendous amount of work in Taiwan in the 90s. And it culminated with us being awarded Taipei 101.
And Taipei 101 would be the sort of benchmark by which dampers were changed from just sort of something that you hid away in a closet at the top of a building to something that you could display and bring into the architecture.
Since 1999, Motioneering has led the way in motion control and damping solutions for tall buildings and other structures. With over 300 projects completed, we've designed, constructed, and monitored the performance for structures and damping systems on every continent. We welcome you to join us as we look back at the past 25 years.
It started with the wind engineering. So RWDI started off the project with looking at different configurations of the building to reduce the motion and make the structure more comfortable for occupants.
Hi, my name is Jameson Robinson, and I'm the Vice President of Operations for Motioneering. Our first project with Motioneering was Taipei 101.
This, at the time, was the tallest building in the world, or would be. Hello, my name is Anton Davies. I'm one of the founding partners of RWDI. So getting the team together, we had to figure out how we were going to actually deliver a 660 metric ton ball 400 and so meters up in the air. Well, it came down to the fact that not only did they want us to figure out how to do it, they actually wanted us to deliver this damper.
The record was broken with the twist of a golden bolt as workers attached a 60-meter spire to the 101-story structure. It now towers 508 meters, dominating the skyline of the capital of Taipei.
Taipei 101 was a bit different for the company because it's a design-build contract. So it made sense at the time to form a separate company that could be structured to take on design, construction, commissioning, and even maintenance work.
We tried to maintain a team morale that kept the group very close together. And during my involvement with Motioneering, it was a very close-knit group, and it still is. Hi, I'm Scott Gamble. I was the technical director at Motioneering and the general manager later on between the years of 2000 and 2007. Taipei 101 would be the sort of benchmark by which dampers were changed from just sort of something that you hid away in a closet at the top of a building to something that you could display and bring into the architecture.
Once our engineers and contractors had sorted out the design and the construction methodology, and then in fact very successfully completed the installation of this massive steel ball. Of course, we needed to show it off a little bit, and we had a good relationship with the Canadian Trade Office in Taipei.
We threw this big party at the top of Taipei 101, and it was a really cool event. I remember being able to showcase our work on the tuned mass damper and being able to talk about the wind engineering that the company had done leading up to that. And we were on the patio overlooking the city at sunset. Just a memorable moment for me. I think that feeling of trust that people get when a challenge is put in their lap. They're not told exactly how to tackle it, because perhaps we don't even know how to tackle it or how to solve it at the beginning, but are given that freedom to be able to develop a solution and implement it.
Okay, whenever you're ready.
Okay. My name is Trevor Haskett. I'm a senior technical director in Motioneering, and I've been with the company 24 and a half years.
Hello, my name is Andy Smith. I'm a senior technical director with Motioneering. I've been with the company for 21 years now.
I think the most memorable slash surreal moment I had was on top of an antenna tower on 731 Lexington Avenue. It was an open tricord truss, about 140 feet tall above the top of the building. Fall rest safety gear. The antenna installation guy was up there with me, and he taps me on the shoulder and goes, "Look up, Peregrine Falcon." And I look up and there's a Falcon sitting right 6 feet behind me. It was surreal. And then it shuffled, spread its wings, and just fell off and sailed out of sight across the city. It was awesome.
Probably the most memorable moment for me was being in the Halifax Control Tower during Hurricane Juan. We were testing some vibration absorbers for a radar installation there and didn't get out on time, so I ended up spending the whole night in the control tower as the hurricane rolled through, and it was a noise and vibration unlike anything I've felt before. Another memorable project was the Grand Canyon Skywalk.
RWDI and Motioneering were involved from its very beginning, from its very inception, when the owner was thinking about building this structure that would be a feature for people to come and visit and people to be able to experience the Grand Canyon in a different way. And so people like myself, who aren't crazy about heights, who are standing on the glass floor looking 3,000 feet down, could feel safer, and you know, you're still getting that experience, the visual experience, but perhaps not the vibration experience.
So we employed 3 tune mass dampers in the end to control the motions, and so it didn't behave like a big diving board.
One of the projects we don't have quite as much billing for is Madison Square Gardens. They did a big retrofit some number of years ago and put 2 sky bridges across the interior without it changing the supporting structure at all. The pedestrian loads during concerts and hockey games were expected to cause perceptible vibration. They wanted that fixed, so we put 5 tuned mass dampers into each of the sky bridges, hidden in a very, very thin floor that people sit and stand on, and other people are behind and can look underneath. It was really neat. We got to go back there and see how they performed with instrumentation during hockey games and concerts, and yeah, make sure everything worked well.
You know, where do I see Motioneering in 5, 10, 25 years?
25 years from now, what would I like to see? I'd like to be able to see something in 25 years.
I see us doubling in size in 5 years, doubling in size again in by 10, and perhaps beyond that.
I would hope that the success that we've had over the last 25 years will continue, and that we'll be able to innovate and bring new things to the industry.
One of the things we pride ourselves in is continued innovation and developing new products. We're always developing new ways to do things to control motions.
In the next 5 to 10 years, technology is going to become more and more a part of our solutions, not just our analysis, but the things that we deploy out in the field. You can expect us to start using some active and semi-active components, I think, in solutions that are even better tailored for the clients.
I see us really continuing to push the envelope and create more innovative products and more innovative solutions as we continue to grow. I am actually afraid of heights if I feel that there's not something that's there that is keeping me safe.
I am afraid of heights. It's not a good combination when you're on new tall buildings with no walls yet.
Trevor's not. I am not afraid of heights. Peregrine Falcon story.
Yes. Basically, if I'm on a roof of a building, I don't want to be within 2 meters of the edge. I'm sure I'd end up on the ground.